Oh my gosh, where did you get that? Hey there everyone, welcome to Toy Story Land. Today we're doing something a little bit unique, something I haven't done that much, but I want to do more in the future. I'm taking a deep dive into Toy Story Midway Mania. We're going to show you some of the merchandise, some of the queue lines, both in and out, and of course, the merchandise that you can find inside. In addition, I'm going to show you how to get the absolute best score possible. Let's do it. This is very difficult to do in film, but I wanted to dedicate today, or at least part of the day, to show you how to do this. Because a lot of friends have asked me, Michael, how do you get those scores? 300,000 or 250 or whatever it is. Today, I'm gonna show you how. First things first, relax those arms. Don't hold around heavy camera equipment like some people as you're walking in there. So you have a lot of strength in those arms so you can go full throttle inside of the game, because you're gonna wanna pull that cord inside of the game as fast as possible. Now let's walk through those games before we actually get on board so you have an idea of what we're going for, and then you're gonna see me play inside of the game. The first game is the barnyard. You're gonna see a lot of barn creatures all around, and when you're there, you're gonna wanna look for the little barn house, the hen house, on the either right or left-hand side, depending on where you are. You're going to hit the fox on top of the hen house. It's gonna kind of flip over, move around a little bit. You're gonna see hens start coming out of the hen house, and then you wanna hit all of those hens. It'll reset, you do the fox, and do it again and again. Now, for those who are a little bit more advanced, you can go for the little cow, the little pigs, above the hen house. After you hit two of those pigs, if you're going for the advanced round, you hit those two pigs, you hit the cat behind them, and then you make your way back to the hens in the hen house. This is for more advanced. You make your way through, and then you make your way to the next game. The next game is the lava area. What you're gonna wanna do here is hit all the lava flows coming out of the mountain, right? So those are the ones that hit first. There's one. There's a break, then there's two, there's a break, and then there's three. Clear them all, and you'll get the lava explosion, an eruption of the lava. So cool. After you've done that and the eruption is over, you'll see the meteors start coming in on both sides. Hit both meteors, right, all the way down, one, two, and three. Three hits on each meteor, on each side, and you get the meteor shower. After the meteor shower, you're gonna make your way to the next game, which is Sarge's Army Men. Inside here, you're gonna hit two flying plates, one on the right, one on the left. If you're playing by yourself, very difficult, takes a lot of practice to do, but you can do it. You hit both of those at the same time while they're in the air, at the same time before they go back down behind the mountain, and you'll see 2,000 point plates pop up right in front of you. So cool, you hit them all, you get a really high score. In addition, don't miss the 5,000 point plate, which is gonna be thrown out of the tank in the middle of the mountain. Awesome. Next up, we've got Buzz Lightyear making his way through space. When you're there, you're gonna wanna hit all of the aliens on the ship. They're all worth 100, but if you can get them all to kind of be down on that ship at the same time, you'll unlock Gigabot, which will open his mouth and will give you a super high score. You want to launch as many rings as possible into Gigabot's mouth, but the first round, don't worry about it too much. It's only worth 100 points, but then he'll open his mouth for much more points. When he's got his 100 points with the mouth open, skip it and try some of the other targets around the screen. When it opens up with the 2,000 points or whatever that is, the higher scores, go for those much higher targets. Now let's head on board, I'm gonna show you even more. Once you're inside the game, the first round pops up, you'll see different characters with those targets, they're holding it up for you. This is the practice round. Relax, just kind of get a feel for the controls. Don't stress out too much, because then we're moving on to the very first round. Now here is the barnyard scene, and you can see we are shooting for that fox. On top of the hen house, the fox flips over, and there go the hens. Make sure you hit as many of those hens, there's three that come out, and the fox reappears. So make sure you keep that method going with the fox and the hens. Now, if you do have that extra time, go for the pigs that are just above. See, one and two. Then that cat appears right back there. So we want to keep that method going the entire time, and that's how you get the highest score in this first game. Now, if you can't get the pigs right out off the bat, don't worry. That's for more for the expert mode, but it's there for when you're ready. Now, the lava. First, we're going to hit that first one. You saw it went away, and now we're going to shoot other targets. Now, we've got two others. Both targets hit onto other targets, and there are three pieces of lava. We're going to hit all three, one, two, and three. The eruption happens, and there it is. You can see balloons coming out of the top as the eruption goes through. Now, meteors on the right and left. There's one, two, and three. Both meteors have been hit. And we're going to continue on. Almost there. There's that first one. Second one. And the 500 target. And then you can see the meteor shower. Boom. And those meteors come down. You shoot all those balloons. You get a high score. In Sarge's area, you'll hit this one plate coming up on the left-hand side. Use that 2,000 point plate. One on each side until you unlock all the flying plates. Very difficult to do by yourself. I wasn't able to do it this time. But when you run through it, you'll be able to actually catch those plates flying. With Buzz Lightyear, you want to hit all those little green men down on that middle rocket all at once. They have to be kind of all down at the same time. Very difficult to do at first. Now, when you see his mouth open for 100 points, just skip that. Skip the 100 point, not worth it. Then 500 points, as many rings as possible into his mouth, then off to other targets, 1,000, 5,000 points, and then there's the 1,000 mouth. Open it up and shoot those rings in. You continue on this path, and you can see Gigabot continues to open his mouth. Now, if you got it early enough, Gigabot will open his mouth twice at the 2,000 point level. That's where you can really get some super high points. Now, for rootin', tootin', shootin', you want to hit every single target once. This comes down to accuracy and speed. You want to be as fast as possible, but also as accurate as possible. What I like to do here is I like to open all the targets and then hit all those center ones. That way I know what I've already opened and what I need to open a second time. So you can see I hit that middle one again. But the idea is you want to make sure you open all of them, hit all of them, and then all the points will open for 2,000 point targets. Now, as you make your way to the next section, just hit as many of those high point targets as possible. Go for the 1,000 and 2,000s, 500s when you see them, and you'll make your way to the mine train. At the mine train, you want to hit all those mine cars as fast as possible. Try not to miss a single one. The bats up above are for like expert mode if you're really, really quick. I haven't gotten to that point yet, but if you're quick enough, you can hit those bats as well. Hit that final target as fast as you can. Every single shot counts here, and then you make your way to the final score. Now, while we're here together, a very kind friend is helping me film all this, and so what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna help this friend walk them through what it's like to try and get that better score. This friend has never gotten over 100,000 before, so we're gonna help them try and get over their best score. You've seen the secrets, you've seen the tips. Now let's put it into action. I feel like kind of going through it together will be super helpful. Inside the practice game now, relax that arm, take it easy, just kind of get an idea of the aim. We're gonna get to those real games and really score those points. Don't forget that fox on top of the hen house, right? To your left, down, down. There he is, get that fox on that hen house. Here come the hens. Make sure you get all the hens. And then when you have time in between, get the pigs up above. So get that, yeah, the fox and hen house are the priority. Then those pigs. Oh, don't forget the pigs. There you go. The hen, 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 there you go. Oh, you almost missed it. There you go, you got it. There you go, you got it. Yeah. Well done, and you just round with 20,800 for that first round. Now the first few seconds, grab that first thing of lava up above, great. Now grab some other things, and go for that lava again. Two of those pieces of lava, one and two, very good. Now some more, there you go, triceratops. Now the three pieces of lava, don't miss them, there you go. One, two, and three, great job. Now get all those blends as many as you can. Great, great job. Focus near the top of the volcano. Now what we're gonna do is get those two meteors on the right and left. There's one, good. Try and hit that one two more times. There's a five, and then almost. Great, you got one meteor. So the idea is to get both meteors, but you're definitely getting better. I love it. At 37,800, let's hit Green Army Man. Now don't forget the plate. It'll be jumping up in about four, three, two, one. Get that guy. And the other one, almost. You want to try him both. Here it comes there. I get that other one, almost. Now you want to try and hit some other targets. That one's not working so well. There you go. It's a little bit difficult to get this one alone, so you want to try and go for some of the other targets, the 1,000-point one, the gold one on your left right there. Now this one is especially difficult to do alone, but you want to try and get all the green army men on top, little green men. This one's especially hard to do by yourself. All of them at one time have to be down. And almost, you didn't quite get it. That's okay. Let them reset. You want to let them reset if you can't get it. And go for the 5,000 in the upper left. Upper left, 5,000, the UFO. There you go. Now wait for them all to pop up and go. Get them all of them, all of them. As fast as you can. Almost got them. Oh, not quite. They have to be down at the same time. Go for the 5,000 over there. Higher, higher, higher. Almost got it. Yeah. Good job. We're at 66,700. Now, root and shoot and shoot and try and shoot as accurately and as fast as you can. Open them up, shoot those high value targets. There you go. Get all those thousands and 500s. Keep going. There you go. Open all those up, too, and getting those high values. Go for that 1,000, go for the 2,000. 500, very good. Don't forget those 2,000s, 1,000. Very good. Shoot, aim, and go. Shoot, aim, and go. Many as you can. Now, I know the bats are worth a lot, but you want to try and get these up to 5,000. Great 5,000. Great 5,000. As fast as you can. Go, go, go. Faster, faster. Almost there. Keep going. You got this. Yeah. Great job. That was a fantastic run. Let's see if we get over 100. with those tips? Let's find out. Come on. Yes, I think that's your best ever. 137,800. Well, well done. Super impressed. Wow. Almost best in the vehicle. You were really close. 137,800 is a great, great score, especially because you're going against yourself. That's the key to remember here. It's against your own personal best score. Now let's take a deeper dive into the gift shop here as you exit Toy Story Midway Mania. It's a relatively new spot that you can find right as you exit. Now, either one of those different tracks here, Toy Story Midway Mania, will lead you to this gift shop. You'll notice that the theme of this gift shop is actually following along with Toy Story, where it kind of looks like cardboard. Right here, all over, and you can find like paintings or drawings on the wall, along with those barrel of monkeys hanging from the ceiling. Great feel of the whole place. Now that theme follows all the way through, and you can find every single Toy Story item that you can possibly imagine. I'm saying possibly because there are a couple more outside, but you can see we've got the Buzz Lightyear bubble blower, we've got shirts, we've got throws, we have this cool Pixar toy box with the evil Emperor Zurg. We've also got lots of plush characters. I saw more earlier. Some kid shirts below. Take a look at this one. This is a great kid shirt right there. Love that one. They've got the red one as well, and they've got a pink one on the side. I think they're all, yep, they're all different designs here. Now, if you're looking for the real Mr. Potato Head, you can find him here, whether it's the individual Mr. Potato Head or the pack of two. See, this is nice. You've got the regular Potato Head here, and you've also got the Buzz Lightyear version. I love that. We've also got toy sets here, which are super nice. You can find the mini figurines there, and you've got these sweatshirts. I like these sweatshirts a lot. You can see those Toy Story characters all from those movies. $39.99. Now, for those who love the Wishable collection at Disney, they've got a lot of different ones for a Toy Story. There's Woody right there with Andy on his foot. Love that. Then inside of these little packs, which contain a random wishable, you've got Jessie, you've got Trixie, you've got the Barker, Mr. Potato Head, I like that. And you've got Bo Peep, the new version, right there with her sheep. Love those. Now, when I was a kid, these parachuting skydiving figures were super, super popular. You'd toss them from the top balcony, wherever it was, and toss them down, see how they float down to the ground. Always a lot of fun. You've got Buzz and Woody here. Now, we're gonna get some of the toys over there in a minute, but I wanna show you some of these really cool items that they have that I've only seen inside of this gift shop. Look at this space crane here. It's a fully functioning claw machine. So you can use it to collect the little green men inside. And my guess is, and this is just a guess, I might have to try one day, is to actually, you can put something else in there, like some other toys, and maybe have your family members, your friends, try and like win their prize as they come by. I don't know, it seems like such a cool concept. Now for the youngest ones in your traveling party, you can find these really cool I'm Just Happy to Be Here shirt, along with another Toy Story one with those characters all building something. I like how they have very similar style. So let's say you have different age groups in your family. Everyone can have a Toy Story shirt, but not the exact same design. That's nice. You got these bouncy balls here. And then if you really want your own real Slinky Dog from the past, you can find one inside of here. It's the talking action figure Slinky Dog. You can see it's an actual Slinky inside. You pull him along with that chain. So cool. Here's another great shirt, Hollywood Studios, with the alien kind of going by and pointing at Hollywood Studios. And look at the hat. Love the ears. I have been chosen by the claw. Love it. Now, another one of those toys, which I'm sure is super popular, is this wind-up flying Buzz Lightyear, where you actually put him inside of this little thing right here. You pull a string, as far as I remember, and then he flies away. Super cool. I remember as a kid, we had some of these. There was one my sister had, like a fairy or something like that. It would fly in the air. So cool. Now, this is super cool. This is actually wings that you can get for someone in your traveling party. It's meant for those who are three and older, but on the back, it's so cool. You actually put it on. Take a look at the image right there. You put it on, and then the wings expand. And it's just basically it's not a backpack. You don't put anything in it. You just have your own Buzz Lightyear wings. I love that idea. Right below them for $19.99, we've got the claw. You can have your own claw from Buzz Lightyear. You can see it's one of those little grapplers you pull right here, and the little grapple hook can grab whatever you're going for. Following along with that, we've got more Buzz Lightyear, from the sweatshirts to the actual action figure that makes those sounds and lights and wings and all. And you can even get your own Buzz Lightyear arm communicator. Now, when I was younger, these pull toys were extremely popular. You pull them back and then they fly away, and Buzz has got his own right there inside of that Space Ranger vehicle. And below him, we've got some smaller figures of Buzz, and then below him there, we got the bucket of soldiers, the green army men you can find. They're right there, and their motto, leave no man behind. The bucket of soldiers is $17.95, and you get a lot of them inside of that bucket. It's actually relatively large. I mean, there's my hand
There's the bucket. Pretty large.
Now, we've made our way to the arts and drawing section where you can find different notebooks, pens. Love the different pens from Pixar. You can even find the lamp pen. Love that. Buzz Lightyear pen case there. And some great character pens like the aliens and Slinky Dog. And then you've got all the different colors in the world from Pixar. So you can start animating at home. You know, that's what they're thinking of. Then we've got these items down here. Another pen and pencil case. Then next to all of that, we've got the Forky section. The Forky section includes the Forky hat. Love that one. You've got the holiday Forky. Love that. Then you've got the brush. Take a look at the $16.99 Forky. Stands up on your dresser or nightstand or whatever, wherever it is. On the back is a brush. That's great. I hadn't seen that before. Now you can actually match a younger one in your traveling party where you sell the other shirt. I'm just happy to be here in this tank top. $29.99. But next to it all, I think the most popular Forky item, I would guess, is the sweatshirt. The sweatshirt's $46.99 and it includes this fluffy material along with Forky on the front. You can see they've got them in just about every single size. Very fluffy. Going along with the Forky style, I'm new here for the youngest member in your traveling party. I love that. Look at that. It's super cute. And then below, we've got some more Toy Story and Woody items. There he is. There's a new sheriff in town. Again, for the youngest ones and newest travelers as part of your party. $19.99 for this one. Bo Peep is an extremely popular character, and you can see this dress here hanging with my peeps. Love that. Super cool. You can see Bo Peep below. And then you've got the leggings below there, where you can see the sheep right there. It kind of goes perfectly. You got the dress or the top with the leggings of the sheep. Perfect combo there. Now this is super cool. You can see it's Forky. He actually walks around. So you somehow you'd be able to make him wobble and walk around the room as you're playing with him and other toys. And he has a toy detector technology. Not sure what that is all about, but it sounds super cool. See right there? Toy detector. Over here, homemade Forky shirt. Next to him, we've got I'm just happy to be here again. And then above, we've got these worried looking Forky's socks. That's pretty funny. And then below, we've got the rainbow. And for the toes, that's nice. I like it's like a little combo there. Now, instead of the standard Slinky, if you want kind of like the light up one, I have this one. It's a really cool item. You can actually find him all around Toy Story Land, not just here inside of this gift store, but he's super nice. Then you've got the adult sweatshirt, and I like this one a lot with Buzz and Woody. Then below, you've got your own coaster track. For those who love Slinky Dog Dash so much, you put Slinky in here, and then he launches off from that launcher inside of this pack. Awesome. Now down here, we've got the Toy Story Land hats. Love those. And then play all day shirt for younger ones in your traveling party. Now take a look here. We've got Woody and Jessie, both with those strings you can find in the back. And I found out what the toy detector means. It means that they can detect other toys with the same technology around them, and it unlocks different phrases that they'll say. Maybe they'll interact with Forky in some way or interact with Buzz or Jessie. So they're actually talking to each other with the special technology. That's awesome. Now we've got the Toy Story barn here, like from the movie. Love that. All those different characters in there. Now, for those who love the headbands, the Slinky Dog headband is extremely popular. You can see a lot of them here, and you can find more of him all around of Toy Story Land. I love this shirt here. It's a pink one with the red kind of circling around. Super nice with all of those Toy Story characters, including some of the newer ones. In addition to the girls' version, you've got the boys' version, $36.99 for this one. Again, this ringer style, I really like it. I feel like that's super nice. Now, we've got lots of mugs from Toy Story Land inside of this gift shop. I love a lot of these, even including the ones where you can actually get Forky with your mug. That's great. This one probably is my favorite, I think so, because you not only see the Toy Story characters, you can actually see some of those park icons for the handle. That's great, but of course, we've got to talk about another one of my favorites, the Mr. Potato Head one. That's his hat is the top. I love that so much, but a lot of great mugs here, including this one, which is actually more of a tumbler. So cool. Beach towels, they've got the Pixar ball and some of those characters from a Toy Story, including Duke Kaboom from that new movie. Speaking of Duke, you can find a cool shirt here. This is a 3/4 length sleeve shirt. Not a big fan of those, but it is a great design on the front. Love that design. In addition, we've got some Toy Story die-cast race characters. You can actually see those little cars will run around. Maybe a little track, who knows? I love the designs, especially the Zurg one. That is great. Below, we've got RC driving around with that steering wheel. So you can actually drive him around and play with him. That's great. I love the RC toys. Sure enough, we've got Rex, and I love his box. Can I just talk about his box for a moment? The fact that it looks like he's just kind of chomped his way out of there.
That's great. He's got 11 phrases that he can talk to, but he's also, again, got the toy detector technology, so he can talk to other Toy Story characters that have the same technology. Now we get to some of those adult collared shirts here. I love the Pizza Planet here, green with the red Pizza Planet, $59.99, but these shirts are just so cool. Now, in addition to the aliens that you can find with the space crane, you can actually get your own bucket of aliens. Right there, you see that? The claw is calling to all of them. I'm not sure if they're the exact same ones, but the size is super close. I would think that you could probably use them inside of the space crane there. Now, for those who love puzzles, you can find the 1,000-piece puzzle here, the signature puzzle with some of those Toy Story characters. In addition, we've got the little green men in those alien swirling saucer vehicles kind of making their way around. They're these pullback. They're the pullback type, so you kind of hang on to them, pull them back, and they fly away. Super cool. Now, I love the back of this sweatshirt here. You can see it's the Pixar ball and the lamp. Love that. There together is the hood, is the inside of the hood. Love that. Next to it, we've got the gray shirt right there. So it's a similar version, but with the gray, and I don't see a lamp with that one. I do see it with this one. Over here, you can see we've got the Pixar ball headbands. Take a look right there, the ball up above. It's made of kind of that sequins that we've seen before. Love those, $34.99. Below, we can see the Pixar background with the clouds and the Pixar ball. Then we've got the hat. Love the hat, especially for the holiday season. Then we've got the headbands, which are great. You've got Ducky right there. Love that. And then Bunny is behind him. And then you've got this other headband here, which is the Pixar ball. And then you kind of have this rope style underneath. $13.99 for this one. Now you know how iconic the Pixar ball is. We've got the Pixar ball hat. Love that. Green, yellow, and orange. Then up above, we got the Pixar ball plush. Look how large that is. Relatively large. Now, along with those full figures that we've seen around, you also have the evil Emperor Zurg. And if you push right there, you can hear his catchphrases. I will rule the galaxy. Now below, we've got these great alien remixes. These I absolutely love. You can see there's an Incredibles. There's a Boo. There's a toy right there. Hello. And there's another. There's a Woody. There's a Woody little green man. I love this. This is so great. There's even more below. You see all these? There's one right there. That is awesome. I love all of these so much. The remixes, $9.99, super, super popular. And below, we've got smaller versions of the remixes. Kind of these smaller ones right there. I love these. This one, this buzz fell over. But you can see them all inside of these larger boxes. I love it. So, so cool. Closer view of some of those different designs, the remixes. There's a Coco one, along with an Up one. See right there? And even a Sully. Wow. I've always been a fan of these collared shirts that are made of more of that silky material. Super nice one here. You can see all those Toy Story characters, $59.99 for that adult shirt. More of the remix characters below, same ones we saw earlier, and the Zurg Popper with those little popping balls. That's super nice, like he's shooting down Buzz Lightyear in the elevator. Now, in addition to some of the other plush characters that we saw, we've got some other ones here, like Ducky and Bunny, love them, Buzz and Woody, know and love them, and then you've got even more characters down here. You've got Jesse, you've got Bullseye, and below, there's more Forky, holiday version and standard version, then all the way around in the back, we've got some more of those little green men. These Loungefly design bags at Disney are extremely popular, and you can see we've got Bo Peep. We've got kind of it's a Santa-style bag with Forky on the front, little green man, but he's the smaller version of that bag. You've got Woody, you've got Buzz, and then you've got the holiday ones below. Tis the Season, which you can find all around Walt Disney World, Toy Story Land. I played there, square backpack, it's a shoulder bag, love that. Then you've got the full, large-size Buzz Lightyear version without wings. I'm pretty sure no wings on this one. Double checking. Oh, wait a minute. Yes, there are indeed wings right inside of there. I just want to double check that. Sure enough, this bag is here, $39.99. Love the Loungefly ones, though. Love that badge. Sheriff Woody. Take a look at some of these pins here that are very unique to this store. You've got Toy Story Land, Slinky Dog Dash. Then you've got some of these very special holiday ones there. Love that. Play all day. Hanging with my peeps and more. Then below we've got the limited release and specialty pin, the mystery ones there. You've got Woody as the magnet. You've got lanyards. You've got all sorts of these pins. We saw the pins earlier. Then we've got these great holiday ornaments here. You can see the lamp jumping on the ball. And there's, of course, from inside Toy Story Land, the cookie. It's a cookie. Love that. And then you've got the teacups right there with Squeaker and an LGM, Little Green Man. I love these. These ornaments are great.
It's easy to miss the store as you're making your way out of Toy Story Midway Mania, but I recommend stopping by. I got some cool stuff. This queue has a lot of cool things all throughout in Toy Story Midway Mania, but don't forget to check Popsicle Stick Wall, great background, another great one. Of course, the checkerboard wall. Both fantastic backdrops for photos.
Walking through, you'll find a lot of different toys from the past and present, including domino benches. Take a look at these. You can actually take a seat on your way out and just relax inside Toy Story Land. Kind of a hidden spot there. Dino Glide plane here, along with an army man, and blocks, dice, and tape on paper. I mean, some of the details as you walk through, take the time to look, even look up. There's a straw holding up lights. Toy Story Mania can be found inside of a Toy Story Land here at Hollywood Studios. You'll notice that it looks like a carnival right up front. We're going inside, we're gonna walk through, and light basically takes us through a cardboard construction site where toys have put different things together to make us feel welcome. Inside of the fold-up boardwalk backgrounds, this is the box we're walking into, you'll notice that the line kind of takes us through what the toys may experience as they're in Andy's backyard. And remember, they've set all of this up. So you can see it's kind of like a box that's semi-open. On each side, they've kind of opened it up for us to walk through. Now that's a sticker I love on the side of this box. Made in America, the USA, along with that code you get for purchasing it. We walk through and we see more of these cardboard cutouts all throughout. Look, they're even in that vehicle on the ride. Now you can see we've shrunk down to the size of a toy as we walk through this line, because you can see different toys like dominoes and these little blocks here with letters on them have all been kind of increased in size. So they're larger and we are becoming smaller as we walk through. You can even see Uno cards, and they've got games that you can play right there. Now this box is related to the game we're about to play. You can see radio controlled tramps and the spring action shooters that launch 10 different projectiles. We're about to ride in this attraction, so they've kind of put it together for us so we as toys can enjoy it. Now inside this toy box here, you can see they've set up the carnival atmosphere where you can see they've got the ring toss. They've got the strong man who's holding up the 2,000 pound dumbbell weight. They've got the fortune teller, this is Potato Head, carousel, and more. Now once you're inside, you can see there's a lot of toys and games you can play. They even got Etch-A-Sketch here where you can try and guess what it is. To infinity and beyond. To infinity and beyond. I love it. Games from Monopoly Money to cutouts and board games on the ground and the ceiling. So many cool things to see. In the queue, you can see Mr. Potato Head is actually going to talk to us here. He's awesome. He's actually can interact with you and see you as you walk by. Now while you're in line, you can play the Disney Parks game. And once you do a certain amount in the game, you can actually unlock a different thing that you can see in line. It's awesome. Once you complete a certain amount inside the game, in your hand, on your phone, play Disney Parks app, something special happens here. Now there are two tracks inside of Toy Story Midway Mania. One's the newer one, one's the older one. There is no difference. The only difference is like the direction that you turn in. The games themselves are the exact same. Bestest hour right there, 297,400. That's very good. So bestest hour, but we're going for best today or best this month, one day. Practice makes perfect. Cannot overstress that. Practice, practice, practice. Now as we make our way out, you can see the exit queue has a tremendous amount of fun drawings throughout. You can find, look at this, one-eyed Bart has escaped from jail. He's wanted. On that side, you can find the very cool binoculars right there. Love that. Chuckles, the clown, and so much more. Just take the time as you exit to look around, see those drawings, see the cardboard of the boxes, the things that have already been opened. It's just so cool how they put this together. Even this is to its side. See how this is kind of sideways here, just to kind of show that they took any little thing and just put it on the wall. Right there, I love that. Sheriff Woody is on the trail. Love that, even puzzles as well. It's just like a huge combination of all sorts of different toys and cardboard and drawings. It's awesome. Bart will never get away. Woody always saves the day. Now I mentioned two different tracks. This is the newer one. Again, the difference is not super important just because they're the same exact ride. Just know that there are two different tracks that you could get sent down. So if you say to yourself, oh, wait a minute, I don't remember this path, it means that you're on the newer, or perhaps if you've gone down this one, the older track, but there are two. Inside this newer track here, you'll actually see the door along with the windows inside of Andy's room. You can see the cloud wallpaper too, which you know I love. And And you can see it's a little bit different from the style on the other side of the building. They have two because it is so incredibly popular.
Now I'm going to put the camera down and try and get the absolute best score I have ever gotten. I think my best is like 360, somewhere in there, 370 maybe. I can't remember exactly. It's so many times. But we're gonna go for the best I have ever achieved. That round felt great. Let's see how it looks. 315,100. Not bad. That's how we do it. A lot of practice. That's the key. A lot of practice. 315,100. Best this hour. Yeah. 326,400 playing together. Very impressive. 326,400. Best this hour. I was like 10,000 points away from best today. See how close? But practice. Now, since I just found out that the Num Num Cookie is back here at the market, you know we've got to try it. It's outside of Municiburg. Right now, Num Num Cookie available. I'm going to have a small bite. I got my backpack. Grass is going in the backpack for David and for later. From the market here at Hollywood Studios, outside of Municiburg, we're trying the Num Num Cookie, one of my favorite dessert items that you can find at Hollywood Studios. It is, as far as I remember, one of the absolute best. So reminder, I am not having the whole thing here. I am going to have a small piece and bring the rest back for later and for David. Also, while I was there, decided to try the non-alcoholic Pino Colada, which they have right by the market as well. I thought to myself, you know what, that's a non-alcoholic drink that sounds delicious that I haven't tried before. Probably gonna taste like a very standard Pino Colada, but small little snack here, worth a shot. Small little piece of the Num Num Cookie. Bon appetit. Just imagine the softest, gooeyest, best amount of cookie to chocolate ratio. You remember how you like used to walk through the mall and the Mrs. Fields would have like the smell of cookies? It tastes like that smell. So good. Now to try the Pino Colada. Cheers. Good flavor, standard Pino Colada taste. Nothing amazingly incredible, but that's exactly what I was expecting. More coconutty, just by a tiny bit, than maybe a standard Pino Colada. Delicious. If you like that flavor, you're gonna like this.
With less than an hour left in our park time, 15-minute wait for Mickey and Minnie's. That's the shortest I've seen it so far.
There it is, 15 minutes for one of the latest attractions at Walt Disney World.
Dave, your first time trying that final car, we were in row 7. Mickey and Minnie's, a little bit of a different perspective. What'd you think?
It was a nice one. I'm glad we had the chance to see a new perspective, see more of the attraction. It was a totally different experience back there.
Really was. I like that row a lot, but I think it's the third to last car that I like the very best. Now we're off to try a restaurant that I've tried recently. I told David all about it. We're gonna try my favorite calamari at Disney World and ever, favorite calamari ever around, Mama Melrose. Been a long time for David, I think.
Have I been before?
Yeah, I think you have when we were kids.
Okay.
We were real young. So, new experiences. Our calamari has arrived, and now David is going to try it for the very first time. I hope it is as good as I remember. Cross your fingers, here we go.
Okay, David's reaction to my favorite calamari ever, here we go, bon appetit.
I like the calamari. I feel like it's very soft, very nice flavoring garnish on the bread. I don't think it's the most amazing calamari of all time.
What?
I think it's pretty solid, but not as flavorful as I was anticipating, personally. I think it's good. It's very solid calamari, but I feel like we've had better.
We're gonna put some lemon on there, dip it in the sauce, we're gonna get another reaction, but I remember this one. It's just as good as I remember, and I love it. I love it so much.
Perhaps I was too soon to speak on this one. The combination of the sauce and the lemon adds significantly to this calamari. I love the combination of the sauce flavor mixed with that breading, the fried flavors. It's in the top tier of calamari, if you're including the sauce and the lemon. I'm trying to remember some of the other best calamari we've had, but it is very, very good calamari if you make sure you mix it with the sauce and the lemon, so do that.
It's still my favorite of all time. Comes down to you, of course, but this is one I would go out of my way for. Consistently amazing. Yum.
Now it's time for that skirt steak here at Mama Melrose. I have been told that this is an amazing steak. Dave and I are gonna split it up. We're gonna try this. We're gonna see what we think. We're gonna probably order something else as well, but it looks absolutely amazing. Could it be the best steak at Disney? There is only one way to find out. Let's dig in.
First couple bites of the steak, it is delicious. A great tasting steak, kind of that charred outside. The wine reduction, in my opinion, doesn't really add as much. It feel like it's like a different kind of sauce kind of go with it would be even better. But overall, in terms of steaks, this is a great one. This is a top 5 steak for me at Walt Disney World. Doesn't beat Skipper Canteen, doesn't beat Le Cellier, but it is up there. It is one that I can definitely see getting again. The mac and cheese with it has a great flavor. I do like that mac and cheese a lot. That's me. The steak, though, very good. Now it's time to try the shrimp campanelli. It looks delicious. The sautéed shrimp there comes with the sun-dried tomatoes, fresh spinach, and sweet onions. Looking forward to giving this one a try as well. Took a few bites of the shrimp campanelle, and I found out that's how you pronounce it, campanelle. It is delicious. Really good, but nothing amazing. So it's like standard good. You know what I mean? So it's got a good sauce. Love that sauce with it. The shrimp is cooked amazingly well. But of all of the items that we've tried, calamari is the one that really sticks out to me, the one that I absolutely love and can't get enough of. And if I was, when I'm thinking about coming back, and I definitely will be back, I'm gonna get a calamari for like an entree, and that'll be my entree, and it's gonna be, it's that good to me.
I thought it was not bad, not a bad flavor, combination of flavors. Shrimp was solid, and they've got a nice pasta flavor. At first, I smelled it, and I said to myself, I don't know, but it was not bad, pretty good. I don't necessarily see getting either this or the steak again. Calamari would be my entree as well. So, not bad, but no journaling today.
Overall thoughts on Mama Melrose? Really good. The calamari was the true winner, no doubt about it. We'll definitely be back. Thanks so much for being a part of the magic with us today. It was so much fun sharing it all with you. Until next time.
Have a magical day.
And see you real soon. Should we get a Caesar salad next time?